It will be a top five shootout for both the Group A and the methanol-sucking monsters that are the unlimited superboats. So from eight, we are going to go from five, and that is where the shootout for the podium places are going to be. Gee, I'll tell you, the foodies are doing a great job. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're hungry, there's plenty of food still around. Hopefully you've got plenty of liquid in you. Hopefully you're enjoying the racing. So it is going to be Carl Brensel and Hamish Murray now to face the starter. Top eight Stinger, Group A category. These guys down on horsepower, but big on confidence. Nice line out of there, had to straighten himself up just a little bit to avoid the Eltham Island in the middle of the track.
Righto, let's see how they go. It's a big spin!
Well, I tell ya, that was huge. Spin me right round, baby. Carl Brensel, where that boat started coming unstuck was when he went into the first right-hander. He didn't get that radius right, had to readjust himself. Then going into the left-hander, it had already upset him a little bit. Got too close to the inside of that island, then clipped the outside of the following island, and you saw the result there. Our safety crew put back to work again. So very, very exciting times when it comes to this. We got Kate Hoogerbrug up here. Now, Kate, your bloke spat the boat out in that last run in the harvest transport vessel. What happened?
We ran over the edge of an island.
Right. Now, I'm no driver, but I'm pretty sure that's not a good idea.
Yeah, well, it let Gary go back in the water, so we were almost there. We just needed to probably keep the foot down and maybe suck up some dirt and get back in, but no, it wasn't to be. And yeah, gutting, but it's racing, and we've had our fair share of that carry on, but it is what it is, and we've just got to move on and keep racing.
Well, that's right. And Wanaka coming up next over the Easter weekend. Are you all set to get down there?
Yeah, well, we've got both our main sponsors down there, so we better pull something out of the bag to keep them happy.
Absolutely. And you said that Gaz Stevens got away with it in the Rapids jet machine earlier in the day when he did about 30 metres throwing dirt out of the jet unit. Well, I don't think I've ever seen anything like that before. Have you?
Oh, I have, but I was in the boat that time.
Right, no worries. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that was Kate Hoogerbrug. And Scruffy, the tugboat just effected the rescue there of Carl Brensel. And that will be the end of Carl Brensel for the night. So now there are seven boats left to run to make it into the top five. Carl Brensel is out. No more playing for you, young man, and they will be absolutely devastated with that, but I'm sure that they'll be fronting up at Wanaka on the Easter weekend. So if you're doing nothing over Easter, get down to the Wanaka track. It's pretty special down there. It'll be the final round of the Eltham New Zealand Jet Sprint Championships, and it is always going to be red hot, the final round. Nothing to lose. 8 months to rebuild a boat. It's just not going to matter. So, Carl Brensel, ladies and gentlemen, Carl Brensel and Hamish Murray, give them a round of applause. All right, so just effecting that rescue, we're just now waiting for Harry Whelans in the MF King machine to get the okay to start the fire in the belly of that machine. Jason Conroy, the man doing the navigational duties in it. So Harry Whelan, the MF King race machine, is now starting. It's got plenty of bling going on the inside of that boat. Lights are flashing. So we are going to see some exciting stuff. Harry Whelans has had a couple of dicey moments throughout the course of the day. This is not the time to be producing dicey moments. So Harry Whelan now coming under starter's orders. No time has been posted to get into the top five of the Stinger Group A. Harry Whelan, Jason Conroy. Oh, Harry Whelan wide. The same sort of thing that Carl Prenzel got into, but Harry Whelan got away with it.
Yeah, he managed to hang on to that really nicely, and he's through the hip and pretty well too.
Yeah, that's right. Well, he spun the wheels a little bit, but he's got on with it. Keeps the momentum going. Now up into the mouth breast sweeper, into the tightening nuts. Tightens up right in there. So Harry Whelan out on track at the moment. Jason Conroy doing the navigational duties. They're going to come into the split. The split is a 40.2921.
As they're making their way down back through the middle of the track now, let's see what time they are going to post in this top eight round. Here they go over the line with a 55.394.
So that is now the benchmark for all of the other Stinger Group A boats to make. That is where they're going to have to get. So now it is really up to it. So, right, we are now going to be casting our eyes down to Andy Ryan in the Joker. His first time racing under lights. Kerri-Ann Allen is doing the navigational duties, the big spotlight.
These guys were looking pretty sharp too last time out, so let's hope that they can build on that and keep on progressing through. Here they go.
So the Joker, Andy Ryan, launching off the line. Very wide lines. He's gone. Andy Ryan went too deep in there as well. Three in a row going very deep out there. Really wide. Andy Ryan-esque, and he got away with it. Doing a brilliant job at the moment. Into the mouth fresh sweeper, around the nut now. Oh, clip the inside of it, clip the outside of it, up on the dirt, back in the water. Can he carry on? No, he can't. And another one gone. And the rescue crew put to effect again. We might need to ask Andy Ryan to turn off the big spotlight on the top of the roll bar there, because the rescue crew now cannot see. They won't be able to see now until Tuesday, having about 480 million watts of bright light shined into their eyeballs. You'd be better off looking at the sun, I would have thought. Hey, I was speaking to a mate of mine, and Jono and Dave, in fact, they're watching us on the live stream here. Jono, he was having a bit of trouble with the missus, you know. So anyway, he was telling me about this. Dave was telling me about it. Next thing, Dave, he walks into the shed, and there's Jono doing a sexy dance in front of the Massey Ferguson, right? He's sitting there going, Jono, what are you doing a sexy dance in front of the Massey Ferguson? Jono replies, well, you know me and the missus haven't been getting along so well, so somebody told me I had to do something sexy to attract her.
And the penny drops. Oh, KV.
So, well, that's the end of Andy Ryan as well. So, out of the three, the top of the first three Group A boats, Harry Whelan, the only one to post a time. Andy Ryan spat it out. Carl Prenzel spat it out. This is the time of the night where it gets super, super exciting. Everybody pushing hard. So, where are we going to go to from here?
There goes the Joker back up on the trailer.
So I just got a message from Australia suggesting I've got a good head for radio. And funnily enough, that's a bloke who's actually got a better head from, well, the other side of the wall. Alright, so trying to work out who's going to be out next. It should be Ollie Silverton. Ollie Silverton came into this round in P5. He'd been leading the charge all day in the top 12. Did not have a good run at all. In fact, was all over the shop. So Ollie Silverton really going to have to lay one down this time. Just casting my eyes down there, just sort of seeing what's going on. Just seeing a bit of, I'm not sure that's smoke or steam coming out of the Ollie Silverton boat. Just sit, the navigator's just taken the helmet off. I think that is the boat that I'm looking at. A bit hard to see from down here, or up here, two down there. Ollie Silverton now off the trailer. The boat is okay. It was a boat further down the line on the ramp.
All right, here we go.
Here we go. Ollie Silverton just off the line. They had a bit of a fade out in the getting into the top eight, and probably did not run their best time at all. So Ollie Silverton now really going to have to get a boogie on. This is going to be interesting, very, very interesting indeed. Now up into the mouth, fresh sweeper into the nut. So left around the Elfirm Island to the far side of the track. This will give us a bit of an idea where the split is. The split at a 39 dead, about 1 second quicker than the time that Harry Whelan's posted. So Ollie Silverton has really lost a lot of momentum under the lights. And a 53.428. So Ollie Silverton in front of Harry Whelan's by 2.9 seconds. So that's not a bad run, considering the last time out Ollie Silverton had a few issues. Seemed to have tidied it up right there. But now comes 222 Firewater, Rick Burke and Elf Kill off the trailer, the Teletubbies. So Rick Burke and Elf Kill, they are your reigning world champions, ladies and gentlemen. And at the moment in about fifth on the New Zealand Points Championship for the Stinger Group A category. They will certainly want to be going a lot better. They posted a time of a 54.341. So, geez, I tell you, the way that the bow of the sprint tech just dug in there. Plenty of water coming up over the bow, straight into the face of a driver and navigator. Rick Burke, a really interesting line down there. Bogged it down on the exit. You really heard the impellers just trying to spin, hit the rev limiter on the exit as well. Down to the fast part of the track.
Yeah, so these guys just having a few minor issues at the moment, but they are very, very determined indeed as they come around the Elfin bend now. Let's see what the split is. We've got a split of 39. So
Slower.
Just by a little bit. Oh, he's just dug it in a wee bit there. Over the line he comes, and it's going to be a 53.896.
So 0.4 slower than Ollie Silverton.
So you think he could probably make up that time if he just gets a little bit smoother through. He might be challenging for that top spot.
Yeah, look, absolutely. Lost a lot of time on the hairpin, and then coming into the final left-hander around Eltham in the middle of the track, knifed it a little bit in there as well. So they're valuable tenths of seconds that just go onto the clock. If you smooth it out, the times will come down. As we now go down to Bevan Muir, Team Tools Racing. Kendra Death is the navigator here. Bevan Muir came into this round with a 54.28. So he needs meter time of a 55.394 posted by Harry Whelans if he's going to progress into the top five. And Bevan Muir has been aggressive right from qualifying round at number one today. So really, Bevan Muir and Kendrick Dent really nice through that hairpin and took a very wide line in and a very wide line out, but didn't wash off any boat speed whatsoever.
These guys looking really, really sharp so far, and yeah, they have been on the pace all day today as well. So just building in confidence and really getting the job done, and that boat is looking very sharp at 39.340, so not as quick as our previous two entries so far. Can they make up any time? It's going to be really, really tough. Round out them, over the line they go. Let's see what they do.
Caught the inside of the tyres on the way through the finish line as well. 54.083, 54.083 into P3. Bevan Muir trying to cut the corner into the finish loop. Caught the inside of the tyres just in front of commentary. So we've seen a couple of people do that. Graham Hill in the Liquid Gold Machine did it earlier as well. So that is very, very tight racing, doing that sort of behaviour. Our next boat will be the locals. Super Mario Ross Travers and his son Shane in the silly seat. The Navigator's chair.
Roscoe just launching off the start line there and getting around that first right hand with absolute ease. Let's see how he goes around the top of the course. Looking pretty good so far. This will tell us. He's just leapt out of the water there a bit. That might cost him a little bit of time. So he really needs to ensure that he nails the rest of this rotation. Picks up that time that he might have lost and post something really, really competitive. Let's see how he goes through the middle of the course and then around to the bottom, and we'll see what his split time is. He needs to be under 40 for sure. It's a 39.5, so pretty good. He is on to a hot lap. Here is our hometown lad, Ross Travers. Round one, final bend, and over the line he goes. What's he going to do? It's a 54.264
into P4. So with a 54.264, he was actually down a little bit on that split. At the moment, we're heading into top five. Harry Whelans is on the bubble in fifth position. His time is a 55.394. Simon Gibbon needs to beat the 55.394 in the Novus Auto Glass Machine. Simon Gibbon is the driver. Paul Tomo Thompson is the navigator. They are just sitting there going through their processes, now being sent off the trailer. So easing the reverse bucket down. So the bow of the boat just got hooked up on the trailer there a little bit. Now they're coming off the trailer. So Simon Gibbon, Paul Tomo Thompson, if they want to feature in the top five, which will determine our podium places, the time they need to beat is a 55.39 set by Harry Whelans. Harry Whelans and Jason Conroy now sitting on the bubble. Cy Gibbon, the boys from North Canterbury. They had a bit of a nightmare of a run earlier.
Right, let's see what these boys can do. Off to a very, very nice start there. Indeed, they need to go quicker than Harry, posting a 55.39. Down to the all-important hairpin. Let's have a look. Not too bad at all. They'll be happy with that. Go, boys. Go. Hammer it.
Yeah, they've got the whip out now. They think they're coming down the straight of the Melbourne Cup. Really got it out at the moment. Up to the top part of the track.
Through the nut they go, and we're going to get a chance now to have a look at the split, which will tell us if they're on a hot lap.
That is the quickest split by 0.1.
Yes, so they are looking like they might be able to grab that top position if they can finish off this rotation. What are they going to do? Simon Gibbon comes around and over the finish line now with a 53.786.
And into position number two. So that is the end of Harry Whelans. This is how the top five for the Group A is going to look. From slowest to fastest, Ross Travers, Bevan Muir, Rick Burke, that man Simon Gibbon and Ollie Silverton will head in to the Group A top five. That is the end of Harry Wheelands, Andy Ryan and Carl Brenzel. We are now going to have a sponsor's ride. This is a sponsor ride with Stewie Latham. I did have some